Chris, welcome back to my channel, The Peaky Boy Career. Right, today I am test riding the 1250 GS. This is actually the bike I'm looking at buying. It's phenomenal, honestly. I've only been on it probably 20 minutes, half an hour. So I've got the low seat on it. I'm 5'8" and that's perfect for me. The normal seat, I was kind of on my tippy toes. But no. This is the rally version. So you get the acro cam with it, and it sounds proper nice. Let's just have a little go up and down here, and I'll show you. The minute I've got it in road mode. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. The quick shift out is so smooth, it's unreal. And to be fair, everyone's just saying to me that these bikes are heavy. You can proper chuck them about, they're not an heavy bike at all, because the weight is distributed so low, they're like Harley Davidsons. You can proper get into the corners in them. You know. Really, really, really nice bike. I'm really, really impressed with this. Shifter, then just you can barely hear anything. This screen is actually taking a lot of the wind off. You could even ride this with your visor open, I'd say. Oh, look at that big black cloud there again. Every time I come out, there's a black cloud. Isn't it? Remember this curly pair? I'm going to bang the left here. But yeah, guys, this is. This is phenomenal, and I believe you get, with the rally version, you get everything as standard. So I believe you get the exhaust as standard, all the crash bars as standard, because they do the upper and lower crash bars. Obviously you don't get your panniers, but the racks are made for the bigger boxes. The exhaust is loud, but not too loud. I'm really liking this, lads. Really, really liking this. So smooth. I think I might be test riding my next boy. Oh, diversion. Yeah, this is proper. I don't know what the hell she's doing here. She's happy about it though. Like I say, I've got the low seat on it. For me, that's perfect. I can get my feet nicely onto the floor. don't feel like I'm on my tippy toes. I don't feel like that I'm pulling up to junctions and I'm unstable. Press for that quick shifter. Really, really impressed. Sixth, it pulled really well. This is phenomenal. Comfortable, it's unreal. I'm currently in road mode. You can change that through that button there. Road, dynamic. That's supposed to, you can give it some beans. Gives you a lot of confidence on this bike. Yeah, it's a big bike, but you can chuck it about. Unfortunately guys, I think the Kawasaki's done. This is phenomenal. I completely overlooked this bike, just for the size of the engine, completely overlooked it. Because I thought 1250, it's going to be dead heavy. It's going to be dead heavy, proper clumsy, whatever the fucking word's called. That hill start amazing. So what you do is you pull the brake in hard. So you go, that obviously that's your brake in. If you pull that in again, that'll go off. So now, if I pull the brake in, one more, that hill start, that's on. Look. Foot eye on the brake, nothing. proper impressed with this. Really impressed. Your knees fit snug, you're out the wind. I mean, you've got a massive area at the front, but you're out the wind completely. I mean, if you're going to spend 18 grand on a bike, you might as well get the sat nav and the panniers close to the wall and all that. Shit-eat, you know what I mean? You ain't gonna get much change out of 20 grand, put it that way. I'm going to ready anything out. I'm just going to whack it on at 40 minutes and see what you think. I'll pull over again in a minute and you can have another look. So when you go on your test ride, they tell you to start off in rain mode, or they advise you to start off in rain mode, then go to road, then go to dynamic. They ask you, well, they've asked me if not to go off-road, or if I go off-road, it's only on shale. So I'll be doing off-road if I'm perfectly honest with you. Not a problem, straight round there, not a problem. Comes the rain. So now what we do now, we say, right, oh man, it's fucking pissing down. Get a dynamic, enduro, rain. Now we're in rain mode. So what that does is, it doesn't give you as much throttle response. Gives you a lot, but it doesn't give you your full beans. So I've got about an hour left on this. All the battery to do is put the fuel in, what I've used. So I'll probably, I don't know, chuck a tenner in or something. I'm going to pull up just here. Should be a little lie-boy. Oh, someone's in it. Couple of doggers. This is phenomenal. I can't get over how good it is, honestly. Honestly. His tyres are like a chicken's lip, higher than that thing. Still have some of these bumps. Not that bad. I believe the rain mode is... So the fuel consumption is the best. I mean, this is a 30-litre tank, this is. So, you know, your car's only a 50-litre tank, probably. So, you know, you can do some miles on it. If you had a full tank, you know, you could easily achieve 300 miles, I'd say, on this. dips. Oh, never that, no, I like that. I do like that. That eats up pretty rapid as well, that does, and them do. Look then, ladies and gents. That is the GS Adventure. Just turn the lights on just to... just to give you a bit of an idea. You've got a big presence there on the road. And I'm, well, 5 foot, I'm 5 foot eight. I'm about 13 stone. You know, I have a big 6 foot, not 20 stone bloke, and I'm handling this quite easy. You have Bridgestone tyres. I'm just really, really impressed with it. I mean, it's been raining, look. I ain't wet at all. Let's get back on it. Ooh. Oh yeah, and this one has got the SOS button. So if you crash, you press that. All the sensors on the bike where they tell them that you've crashed. And it calls the emergency services. Underneath here is a little speaker. So yeah, I'm going to head back now. If I'm honest, I'm glad it rained, because you get to feel the bike in the worst weather, don't you? The meaty grips are phenomenal. Mind I warm up on Mark Kawasaki that quick. Change it to one. Pushes along as well, even in rain mode. It's all sluggish, still give you some beans. I mean, I went in there in my jeans and my RST adventure top, and then you get all the blokes and the full BMW kits matching the bikes and all that malarkey. Oh yeah, that's up to them, but they just look, they kind of looked a little bit down on me, as if say, oh, can't afford this. No, it's a proper smooth bike. I'm really impressed with this. I chop off my bolts in for this. probably get what, 13, 14 grand from the Harley. Couple of grand from the Kawasaki, that's 5 grand, so that's 15 grand for this bike, brand new bike. Fully loaded, fully kitted up. Oh my, get in your own lane. Said is you can change the modes on the fly. So if you go to, I'm riding now, 40 mile an hour ish, so I had to do that, go to road.
Oh.
I'm going to go to off undue road because this is slippy. Now I'm in endurance. And now it's telling me the DCT, they've changed the settings. Have a look at standing up. I mean, obviously there's a lot more wind noise standing up, but you know, it's not that bad. You get underneath this massive screen here, and it's turning. I can just feel it hitting the top of my helmet. Very nice. You feel very plush, the back of it, riding it. There's Boone. Ha ha, Silver! You got me all injured! Most of you fucking probably won't recognise that. But... This is very, very nice. Keep it on the enduro road because the roads are crap. Tenner in it and probably a deposit. This is a phenomenal bike. Phenomenal. So the blasting dynamic for a bit. Got a squeak today. Yeah, look, my foot high far off flat on the floor there. I could have the standard seat, but I'd literally be on my tippy toes. So I could churn some miles out on this bike, telling you guys. don't feel heavy at all to chuck about. Loving the quick shifter as well. Slow down, dickhead. Animated groups off a bit. Cocking the hands. Wheelies on this trailer. It does just fill you with confidence, this bike. Makes you more makes you a better rider. On you. Achoo! COVID. Oh. Twelve o'clock. Half hour left on it. Gutted. So even standing up, your legs just nestle in front of the seat, either side of the tank nicely. Let's go over this bump. go. Stay safe, keep your family safe, and if you can all do one thing for me, please, smile, thank you, and be happy. Ta-ra, me muckers, ta-ra.